Mr. Thompson, better known as CT, on the organ on the bass. Get down, CT. Ain't no harm to feel good. Ain't no harm to clap your hands.
hey, hey. Man, that's too much. That's too much. Hey, that is like way too much for like one person to take, everybody, huh? Hey, welcome to the KJLH Quarantine Concert Series. I wanted to give you guys a taste of the Tower of Power led by my man, Lenny Williams, our very special guest tonight, everybody. Let me give him a proper introduction. Tonight, we have a legend who's been consistent in music for close to five decades. Superstar, R&B legend, singer, songwriter, actor. I'm talking about Mr. Lenny Williams is in the house with me tonight. Man, welcome to tonight's program, man.
What's going on there, Kev? Boy, that took me back there, man. Oh, wow.
I saw you kind of reminiscing, man. I'm like, I wonder what's going on in his head right now. That was 1974, 46 years ago, man.
Yeah, that was a long time ago. We had that album had come out, and it was doing great. And Warner Brothers had us go back to New York, and they were so excited about the show that they gave us all, everybody had their own limo.
Really? And
I was like, where you want to go? I said, I want to go to Harlem. I had my own limo in Harlem, just sitting back, just riding through. It was nice. Yeah, I was young. I was a youngster. Yeah.
I would have loved to have been there, man, just to see, I mean, just the type of movements you would make with that type of music on stage, man. I mean, did you like, you know, bore a hole in your shoes and all that stuff too while you're on stage, man?
Sometimes I'd go back and take a rest while the band was playing. Right. And then I started feeling like I was left out. So, because I grew up playing the trumpet, so then I started practicing my trumpet, then I started singing, and then when the band is playing, then I started playing with the band, and then I got tired, so I started with
the band.
So I put that stuff down and just do my singing. I said, my check gonna be the same, whether I'm singing and playing or just singing. So, I'm from Oakland. What did I do? I just said, I'm just singing.
Yeah. Right, okay. I'll tell you what we're going to do, man. We're going to take a brief break, and we'll come back, and we'll talk a little bit more. But people want to hear that amazing voice of yours. He's going to be singing live tonight, everybody, too. I'm just happy that you're here with us tonight. I have the legendary Lenny Williams on the radio with me tonight, man. That's my job is done. I can retire now.
I can retire now.
All right, brief break, everybody. We're coming back. It's the KJLH Quarantine Concert Series. Of course, it's the best station on the planet, Radio Free 102.3. We're KJLH.
Hey, this is Steve Harvey. If you missed the show this morning, this is what you missed.
Did you see the governor of West Virginia, Jim Justice? He dropped a big old F-bomb.
He's so tired of this COVID-19. He had the podium. Listen, mate, we're going to let all the businesses open up that's supposed to be open up. We're going to open up this some. Now, you can go down there, work if you want to. It's going to be at your own risk. Don't call back down here with us about no money and like that, because we're not having it in West Virginia.
Weekdays from 6 to 10 on your station, 102.3 Radio Free KJLH.
The game is about to start. Get your face out your phone.
Just a minute. I'm completing the 2020 census.
Why do you care?
Listen, the census will impact how and where public funds will flow in our communities each year. If we're counted, we'll get better funding for our schools, even affordable housing.
Wow. Well, I'm going to complete the census now.
All right, then. Let's take a shot.
Complete the census online, by phone, or by mail. Shape your future. Start here at 2020census.gov. Paid for by U.S. Census Bureau.
Announcing a giant used car sale at Worthington Ford with over 600 vehicles on sale and everyone is under warranty. Plus, get a 10-day trial exchange, including with your purchase. Pick a car, pick a truck, drive it 10 days, and make sure you like it. Choose from the largest selection in town. Find the car you love and drive it home with just $95
down. If you've been injured in an accident, choosing the right attorney is critical. Choose a law firm with the experience and success that will help you get the best possible result. Injured? Call the Barnes Firm now. 800-8-MILLION. The attorneys at the Barnes Firm are ready to help 24/7. If you've been injured, call the Barnes Firm now.
Fifth Street, Los Angeles, paid spokesperson, attorney John Sheehan, responsible for this ad. It's Ade Lamar. Is there a senior or frontline healthcare provider in your home in need of a place to quarantine? Now more than ever is that time to convert that existing attached or detached garage into income property in 45 to 90 days. Build a brand new affordable backyard home up to 1,200 square feet. Or convert your garage into a junior ADU. You can build a brand new backyard home with the highest in efficiency green products, and financing is available. If you can dream it, Green Home Showroom can build it. For a free consultation, visit greenhomeshowroom.com or call 888-659-5512. If you own a duplex or a triplex, you can also add an additional unit on your multifamily property lot. All of these options are available to you. Visit greenhomeshowroom.com. That's greenhomeshowroom.com or call 888-659-5512. Green Home Showroom, helping resolve the Southern California housing crisis one project at a time.
Are you an independent contractor, an independent professional? Has COVID-19 set your business back? Were the new California laws taking effect in January already making it harder to keep clients and gigs? If you're part of the millions of people across the country who work for themselves, you need to join the Independent Professionals Association today at indywork.org. That's www.indywork.org. At IPA, they're organizing the contractors, consultants, freelancers, and side giggers, the musicians and beauticians, the barbers and bartenders, the DJs and dog walkers, the drivers and late nighters. IPA is where independent workers get a voice. Join today at indywork.org. And don't forget, the Independent Professionals Association is teaming up with KJLH to answer your questions and bring you information you can count on. Join me, Dominique DeFrima, for a special COVID-19 town hall every Saturday morning right here, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. This week, our topic is COVID-19, the Black Impact, brought to you by the Independent Professionals Association, only on Radio Free 102.3 KJLH.
Do you have questions about being able to purchase a home with little or no money out of pocket? Call the Global Mortgage Hotline at 800-332-3007. Questions about down payment assistance, up to 6% for first-time homebuyers.
Call the Global Mortgage Hotline at 800-322-3007.
Questions about having a minimum FICO score of 620.
Call the Global Mortgage Hotline
at 800-322-3007.
Questions on refinancing your home.
Call the Global Mortgage Hotline.
Questions on buying or selling your home.
Call the Global Mortgage Hotline at 800-322-3007.
Questions on a reverse mortgage.
Call the Global Mortgage Hotline
at 800-322-3007. Call Global Mortgage now at 800-322-3007. Call Global Mortgage today, 800-322-3007.
DRE number 01431187. NMLS number 133193.
I've always wanted to learn another language, but every time I try, it never sticks. So I decided to give Babbel a try, and I really like the teaching method of the app. I started with the beginner lesson on Babbel, and it starts with simple words and phrases, and soon you're putting those words into a conversation. Each lesson takes about 10 to 15 minutes, and they're all really different, which keeps things interesting. The app is really smart. It actually keeps track of the words I'm struggling with so I can practice them and get better. I chose Babbel because it was created by real language teachers. They built it around real life, how people actually communicate, and what they care about. I can't wait to use my new language skills in the real world. Dos cervezas, por favor.
With Babbel, get conversational in Spanish, French, German, and more. It just takes 10 to 15 minutes a day. Now try Babbel free. Just go to Babbel.com or download the Babbel app and start learning a new language today. That's Babbel.com, B-A-B-B-E-L.com.
Radio show.
With 102.3, KJLH, Radio Free.
Yeah, we're back. Back on with the legendary Lenny Williams. And I think Jay is trying to connect too. Jay, can you hear us? I think Jay can hear us, but he's still trying to figure out a way to connect audio. He's working fine earlier from the car, Jay. So I guess all you could do is wave and say hello. Hey, but Lenny, man, I got to ask you this, man. So, I mean, how are you holding up, man, doing this stay-at-home, safer-at-home order, man? I mean, how are you holding up during this pandemic?
We're doing pretty good. Me and the wife just sheltered down, and we go out and take a walk every day. And sometimes I'll take two. And we just... there's Jay.
There you go. Right. Now he's working.
Sometimes you'll take two walks.
Yeah. Jay, look at the colors. You got the same color almost.
Yo, matching, I know, man. Look, matching pumpkins over there, huh? What's going on, man? It's not even October yet.
Lenny says, I'll take a walk every day. Sometimes I'll take two.
Right.
Because I'll be eating all the rest of the time.
Hey, man, tell me about that. Well, cool, man. So have you been creative at all, man, during this pandemic at all? Had a chance to write some songs?
Oh, yeah, most definitely been able to do some writing and everything like that, do some practicing on my guitar. I'm going to come on out and do me my little George Benson imitation after this is all over.
Oh, man, I can't wait for this, man. I can't wait for it. Hey, let's start here, man. Let's talk about the fact that it's been close to 50 years and you're still recording, making hits. And I ask Jay this all the time, too. Where do you find the energy to keep going? I mean, after doing it for almost 50 years.
Well, you get the energy from the crowd.
Right.
You know, from people, you know, talking to you about the business. And also, you know, just, you know, you turn on the radio and you listen to KJLH and you hear the youngsters out there doing their thing. And it just inspires you, you know. And, you know, you see them and you hear them and you say, oh, who is that? And then, you know, next thing you know, they say, oh, that's J.M. Anthony Hamilton, you know, and inspires you. And so, you know, so I just say, listen to the radio, going to church on Sunday, boy, when them little kids get to moaning and groaning and runs around there. I be turning my little tape recorder on my phone at church. Some R&B off of that church music.
Nice.
Yes. Yeah.
And you still playing instruments too, man. I was reading through your bio that you actually played trumpet, man. When was the last time you picked up the trumpet?
Probably about 3 months ago. You know, actually, I went decades without playing my trumpet. Uh-huh. And one time, one of my grandchildren was having some at their school, and they wanted you to come by and do something. So I went by, and I started practicing. I just practiced like a little nursery rhyme, and I was able to play it. So I got excited about it, and then I started really, really practicing. And I got pretty good. Matter of fact, the guy at the college, not too far from here, said I could join the jazz band. And then, I don't know, I got lazy and I just put it down. And so now I got to start. I'm back to square one again on the trumpet.
Oh, nice, nice. Jay, did you hear that piece I played in the beginning, man, from the Tower Park?
No, I didn't hear it, man. I was trying to get on. You know, it's technology now. Once you reach a certain age, man, the technology throws you. And it takes you a while to kind of figure it out. I could see y'all, but I couldn't hear you. But no, I didn't hear the first piece. But
oh my God.
Like I said, I know Mr. Williams from when we did the Tom Jordan show, and he would come on the Sky shows and just turn it out, man. You like, he can still sing that song. That song is just amazing that he can still, you know, at this day and time, still hit them notes, man. It's amazing.
Right.
I got to run up on him now, Jay. I got to get back and run up on him real quick.
And speaking of that golden voice of yours, Mr. Williams, you know, since this is the KJLH quarantine concert series, people are in their living rooms right now. I know you've seen online where they've churned and changed their living rooms into bowling alleys, skating rings. So I'm asking everybody to turn that living
room. Have you seen them turn into the church? Have you seen that?
Yeah, listen, that's nothing new. My brother's been having church in his living room for about 10, 15 years right now. Every time I go back to Louisiana, hey, man, you come speak at the church? I'm like, what? Over what? Just crawl up out the bed, go over there? Okay, yeah, I'm there. So they've been having church in the living room.
He got that
years.
Offering plate, though, don't he?
Oh, no. Yeah. Still got the golden offering plates, man. He still got the classic golden offering plates. There's a song that you sent me to, the Sadie song. Yes. And just can we get like an a cappella version of that, man? I know it's kind of late, but can we get you to sing just a piece of that?
Yeah, that's one of my favorite the Mother's Day songs. I know Mother's Day is coming up. Let's see if we can do a little something. Early one Sunday morning, breakfast was on the table. There was no time to eat. She said to me, boy, hurry to Sunday school. Filled with her Lord of glory.
Wow.
We learned the holy story. She'll always have her dreams, despite the things this troubled world can bring. Oh, say, don't you know we love you, sweet Sadie? There's no one above you, sweet Sadie. If there's a heaven up above, I know she's teaching angels how to love Sadie.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, my God. My goodness. My goodness. I'm going to play this piece back. You did this live 1974. Jay and Lenny, let's see if you guys remember this one right here. Here we go.
You know, it's so easy to get caught in the spider web of love. But it's another thing when you want to try and get away. Heard somebody say it's so very hard to go. Ain't nothing I can say, nothing I can do. I feel so bad, yeah, I feel so blue. I got to make it right for everyone concerned. Even if it's me, if it means just me, what's getting burned? 'Cause I could never marry you and I, babe. Would come, I'd have to pay for my mistake. I can't blame you for what you're doing to me, girl, even though my heart aches. Dreams have all come true just the way you planned them. So I'll just step aside, I'm gonna step aside and lend a helping hand in. I can never make you and I pay. So very hard to go. And I got to leave you, baby.
ladies and gentlemen, please.
It's so hard to go when you love somebody.
Put your hands together, everybody, for Lenny Williams. I mean, this is probably an education for a lot of young people tuned in to the radio tonight who probably only know you for one song, you know. But watching your facial expressions as that song was playing, the song that you did, that was live 1974, right?
Right, yeah.
Now, what was going through your mind, man? I saw you closing your eyes. I mean, just to, you know, listen to the body of work that you created almost 50 years ago, man. I mean, how does it feel today?
Well, it feels good. And I was just kind of thinking about the guys. I know that Mick Gillette playing the trumpet there. He's passed on. And matter of fact, you asked me about when the last time I played trumpet. I have the trumpet that he played on that song. And then also he played on Still a Young Man.
Okay.
And so I was thinking about Mick, thinking about Brent Byers, who also passed away, on the Kungas. Yeah, so thinking about them. And also thinking about that song was kind of laid back. You know, I do it a little faster now, you know.
Oh, you picked up the pace a little bit.
Yeah, but you know what, so we had about five guys mainlining heroin in that band. And so, you know, the youngsters from Houston think that they invented screw music, you know, slowing it down.
Yeah, yeah. I said,
we invented that because when them heroin boys would score in the band, we said, we start out, what is hip? Tell me. And then about the middle of the song, it'd be, what is hip? It'd slow way down. And so, I guess the boys must have scored that night or something like that. Because before the show, because I could tell it was kind of slow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, even to this day, I mean, bands are still trying to emulate the sound, you know, especially if they're incorporating horns. You know, they always refer to it, oh, those tower power horns, you know.
Yeah,
they're
yes,
still
yes,
trying to
yes.
emulate that sound in their music to this day, but just can't quite get it.
But they can't do it.
Exactly. Yeah. No.
And I think it has a lot to do with the fact that they're not playing together long enough. They're going into the studio to create a sound that you haven't been, you know, you haven't been around each other long enough to produce that type of sound, and you don't really feel each other. It's just going into the studio to produce a tower of power sound, and it's just not gonna work. It just doesn't work.
Just looking at charts, right, yeah, but yeah, when you playing in little tiny clubs and the—
Yeah, it gives you a feel, right.
And everything else, you gotta make sure that you concentrate and then you get that sound. Yeah, that definitely enhances what you do, and definitely, you know, gives you a distinct sound for sure.
Where did the name Tower of Power come from?
Yeah.
I have no idea. I was thinking that name came up, right? Yeah, right. Yeah. Yeah, I have no idea.
And how did you land that gig? How did you meet with these cats and become—
Well, it was really interesting. I did a record on Fantasy Records in Oakland.
I remember Fantasy Records in Oakland, man. I remember that studio too, Fantasy Studio.
Well, see, but I was hooked up with Fantasy when they was in San Francisco.
Okay.
Right? And I met John Fogerty over there. He had a little band called the Gollywogs. And the big record that year when I hooked up with Fantasy Records was Roger Collins, She Looking Good. Roger was the big star. And so then I did a record and put it out. And people said, well, when are you going to do a show? I said, well, I don't have a band. I don't know how to, you know, I've never been on stage, you know, anything, right?
Really?
So somebody said, well, there's a little band down in Fremont, California, which is a suburb of Oakland. So they took me down there. It was a little band called the Motown Blue-Eyed Soul Band.
Uh-huh.
So I hooked up with them, and we started rehearsing and getting ready to do gigs, but then half the band was still in high school. So I said, oh, this ain't going to work because I'm singing in clubs, right? I want to sing in clubs. And so I let that go, and fast forward about a couple of years later, I was working on some music with Larry Graham. And me and Larry, he was thinking about leaving Sly, you know, we were working on music, and he said, let's put some horns on this stuff. So he said, I'm gonna call this band called Tower Power to come over. So he called them to come over, and I said, oh, this is the little dude from the Motown Blue Eyed Soul Band. So we reconnected, and I started writing songs for them, and then they was having problems with their lead singer. You know, them lead singers, you know, they got attitudes, right?
They all do, man. Yeah.
Not all of them. Not me. And so then I slid in from a songwriter, you know, to being the lead singer. And you know, next thing I know, I'm on the what's this Zoom with Kevin Nash and J. Anthony Brown.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Wow. Almost 50 years ago, man. That's amazing.
This is a question I always ask all artists, especially when you're a comedian and a thought comes to you.
has there been a moment when you're in, and I don't know how to put this, but you're in a thought comes to your mind, right?
Mm-hmm.
Passionate moment is about to happen. Do you stop and write the thought down, or do you continue with the passionate moment? Because if you don't write it down now, right, it ain't coming back.
It's not coming back, right. Well, I've had both experiences. Stop the passionate moment to write it down, and where I lost it. Yes, right. And I lost it.
And I lost it. I know back in the day we used to always carry this little micro recorder with us. Remember the little cassette? You know that used to be in the answer machines back in the day.
Yes.
For the young people who don't know about that,
or they don't cassette. Know about answer machines.
Right.
Remember you would call your phone and leave it on your phone.
Right. Exactly.
Call your house and leave it at the house.
Exactly.
So when you got home, it would be in the message, right?
Well, man, listen, Lenny, man, you are still amazing to this day. You just released a brand new single that we've been playing for the past maybe 3 weeks to a month now, mm-hmm, called Say So.
Yes.
And I was going through your discography, and you've been consistent, like, for many years, like since the 70s, putting new music out. I mean, seemed like year after year after year after year. Tell us about this new song you just released, man. Say So.
Yeah, I was in the studio working on music. I was working with Levi Caesar, the guitar player that was with Prince and the New Power Generation.
Uh-huh.
Working with him. And then I was doing some work with Derek Allen, DOA. He just produced Kim's new album.
Mm-hmm.
And so I started working on songs. And then I was sending them to Ken Wilson to kind of, you know, because, you know, he's a big time, you know, long time music exec, you know, got those interviews and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I would send it to Ken, and so Ken said, "Yeah, this is sounding really great, Lenny." He said, "But I got a song for you." He said, I just got a song in my possession that I think you could sing." And so he hooked me up with this little youngster out of Columbia, South Carolina, and it was.
That's where I'm from.
Well, that's where you're from. No,
yes, sir.
Sounds so good, right? Yeah. So it was the night after the fight of Wilder and.
The one he shouldn't have lost to. Okay, yeah, we know about that. Yeah. Right.
And so I was supposed to catch a plane down there the next morning. So I go to the airport and they say, "Oh, you don't have a ticket, right?" And so this kid is waiting on me to come down to work in the studio with him. And so I didn't have a ticket. The travel agent had actually booked it for the next month. And so then I had to postpone that and then go the next week. So I went down there, got off the plane, just went straight to the studio. And we stayed in the studio all day. And then the next morning I flew out and sent it to Ken. Ken said, "Oh, yeah, you did your job, Lenny." And boom, here it is on KJLH. I was
got like, a
oh.
hit. Got a hit.
Boom, I got a hit. I haven't heard it, man.
I'm about to play it right now. Everybody, check it out. Brand new from Lenny Williams. It's called Say So. And, of course, you heard it first right here on Radio Free 102.3 KJLH.
I miss you a lot. It's been long enough. Can we talk? I don't want to give up on love we had. I know it's still inside. How you been? I miss hearing your voice. Do you miss me still? And did you have a choice? Been on pause the whole time. Resume, don't press rewind. Yeah. I hid my heart away, hoping you would find it one day. Prefer to keep the hold rather than just let it go. I hid my love away, hoping you would find it some way. It may be hard to tell because I hide my pain so well. Do you want to move on, or do we just stop here? Take it from here. I let you get away. I never should have left it that way. If you give me this chance, I promise there'll be better days. Don't go. That smile you try to hide, you know it always lets me know. My heart has a home, yeah. I fell real hard in love. There's never been another one. So stop until we see the sun. I hit my heart away. Oh.
Man, you haven't haven't missed a beat, boy.
No, not at all, man.
If you're just tuning in, I have the legendary Lenny Williams on the radio with me. We got to take a brief break, though, guys. Wait a second. So, Jay, you got your harmonica?
Yeah, I got it.
We got to sing some. Uh-oh. Going to happen, right? Yeah.
So, so we're going to come back and we're going to hear a blues track, right? And featuring J. Anthony Brown. Jay, you got the right key in the key. What you
Let
got?
Let me see, man. I got so many harmonicas out here. I don't know, man.
We're going to do it in key of G, Jay. G, you know.
Okay, all right. Key of G. I got it right here, yeah.
All right. Don't move, everybody. Keep it here. Welcome to the KJLH Quarantine Concert Series, brought to you by the AIDS Healthcare Foundation. We're coming back to more. The legendary Lenny Williams right here on Radio Free 102.3. We are KJLH.
102.3 Radio Free KJLH is saluting the class of 2020. We're proud of your hard work and accomplishments you've achieved this school year. And KJLH wants to recognize all of our 2020 grads. In our virtual yearbook, Mom and Dad, aunts and uncles, friends and family, show your students how proud you are by submitting photos right now. Go to KJLHradio.com to upload your graduate's photo, along with a few words of encouragement. And some of your graduates could get a phone call from our KJLH on-air personalities to personally congratulate them.
Congratulations!
From 102.3 Radio Free, KJLH.
Announcing a giant used car sale at Worthington Ford with over 600 vehicles on sale and everyone is under warranty. Plus, get a 10-day trial exchange, including with your purchase. Pick a car, pick a truck, drive it 10 days and make sure you like it. Choose from the largest selection in town. Find the car you love and drive it home with just $95 down. That's right, pick any car on the lot, new or used, and $95 down is all it takes. Worthington Ford works with hundreds of lenders, including their own finance company, to get you financed. They own the bank, so they can finance anyone they want to. With over 600 vehicles on sale and everyone is under warranty. Plus, get a 10-day trial exchange, including with your purchase. Pick a car, pick a truck, drive it 10 days, and make sure you like it. This is a giant used car sale going on now at Worthington Ford in Long Beach. Huge selection, huge savings, right off the 405 freeway, Bellflower Boulevard in Long Beach. And they're open until midnight. 10-day trial exchange on your sales,
waterproof credit, see dealer details. In Los Angeles, every kid counts. So let's make sure we fill out the census form and count all kids, particularly those under the age of 5, in order to get federal funds for education, health services, transportation, etc. For your safety, you can self-respond from home in 3 ways. Visit 2020census.gov, call 844-330-2020, or fill out and return the form by mail. And for more information, visit firstla.org/census, because in Los Angeles, all kids count.
Family, it's Adele Lamar. Stop waiting. Stop wondering. Now you can know for sure if you've been infected with the coronavirus. Testing is now available 7 days a week from 9 to 4 p.m. at Charles Ardrew University. Don't wait. Set your appointment today. Charles Ardrew University of Medicine and Science has partnered with the County of Los Angeles and the Martin Luther King Outpatient Center to provide free drive-up COVID-19 testing to the residents of South Los Angeles. Testing is available 7 days a week from 9 to 4 p.m. at 1731 East 120th Street in Watts Willowbrook. Protect yourself and your loved ones by getting tested. Same-day appointments are available, or you can make an appointment today by visiting coronavirus.lacity.org. coronavirus.lacity.org. That's coronavirus.lacity.org.
Social distancing means we create as much physical distance as possible so we don't put others or ourselves at risk of getting the coronavirus. But social distancing doesn't mean being antisocial. Get creative and find ways to connect. Reach out to friends and family. Give them a call. Start a group chat. Share a video. Join an online class. Stay home and stay connected. For the latest tips and information, visit coronavirus.gov. Brought to you by the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians.
These are unprecedented times, which are causing a lot of stress and financial worry for millions of Americans. But here's some good news. If you owe back taxes to the IRS, Optima Tax Relief can reduce the stress in your life by helping you resolve your tax debt right from the safety of your own home. Make no mistake, you don't want to owe the IRS right now. They can take your paycheck and everything you work so hard for. But with Optima on your side, you you may qualify for help that saves you thousands. Their tax professionals specialize in the Fresh Start Initiative, one of the biggest breaks the IRS has ever offered. Optima is A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau and has resolved over $1 billion of tax debt for taxpayers across the nation. So now's the time. For tax help you need, for tax help you trust, call Optima now for a free consultation.
Call 800-587-5688. 800-587-5688. 800-587-5688.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
We have all the risk.
We have all the pre-existing conditions.
But we have what it takes to fight COVID-19.
COVID-19 is devastating Black and brown communities.
To beat COVID-19,
we all need to take these four simple steps.
Stay home.
If you have to go to work, keep 6 feet between you and anyone else.
Wear a mask and hand protection.
And finally, wash your hands often.
For at least 20 seconds.
It's hashtag us against COVID.
Brought to you from our partners at Toyota, proud mobility partner.
Radio show.
Chill. 102.3 KJLH, Radio Free.
All right, we're back.
All righty.
The legendary Lenny Williams. And I had to invite my dude, man, my homie, Jay Anthony Brown. Listen, I called him, I think it was last week, right? I'm like, hey Jay, man, I got Lenny Williams coming on next Wednesday, man. You want to come through and wait, hey, Kerry, hey, listen, man, I got to get my voice, I got to get my microphone, I got to get my monitor, you know, plus I got to get some tracks and everything. I said, no, Jay, I'm not even talking about you singing, man. I don't want you performing. I want you
Let me tell the story.
Go ahead.
So Mr. Lenny Williams, he's done his show. He sung his killer song. The crowd is going crazy. Trust me, they're going crazy. He comes back on stage. I had never seen you sing blues. Uh-huh. So he comes back and he sings a blues song and he kills it. And so when he comes off the stage, I'm like, excuse me, sir, what key is that in? Because people who know me know I play harmonica just good enough to impress people where they think I can really play. So he said, Jay, it's in G. Is that right, sir? He said, G?
G.
I said, oh, I got a G. Let's go back out there and do it again.
I didn't get no extra money either. Hey, Kev, I didn't get no extra money. He didn't think, well, here's $5.
What? For you to come back out on stage.
Nice,
Jay didn't
money.
Pay you nothing. You know what I mean? So I thought it was a huge joke. I'm like, Jay, I'm not asking you to perform or to sing. I ain't know nothing about that. So I brought it up to Liddy the other day. He says, Oh yeah. I'm gonna get a blues track ready, man, because I'm like, oh, Jay was serious? Oh, okay.
Well, here's the thing. I know he can sing it on his end. I'm not gonna play because what's happening, we'll be a little delayed, but I still would like to hear him sing it where he is. So if I tried to play.
No, Jay, you gotta play. You gotta chime in.
Well,
man.
Let me play the track.
Gotta chime track. In. Go and play it on your end, Lenny.
Here we go.
Rock me, baby. Rock me all night long.
I don't even hear the track.
Rock me, baby.
You don't hear the track?
Rock me all night long. I want you to rock me, baby. Like my back ain't got no bone.
Come on, Jay.
I can't.
Like my back ain't got no bone.
I can't hear the track. I really can't hear it. I'm a beatbox for you, man.
Yeah, I did.
Jay is parking out. You parking out. Come on, Jay. Turn my headphones up. I can't hear. Turn my headphones.
I get here, man. I don't want to mess it up. Yes.
All right, there we go. That's all right. Baby. Yes.
Well,
yes,
it's all good. Now, listen, we're running out of time, but listen, we have to. Man, I'm sure every show you do, right? The song that people really, 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 really want to hear you say and Tear Up. Man, I got to ask you this, man. When you were writing that song, putting that song together, recording that song, did you have any clue or idea that that song would become like a timeless masterpiece?
I'd love to say yes, but I didn't know. You know, I did it twice. I did it first on Motown, and I didn't have the talking in it. And it was a little faster. And then I went on the road, and I performed it for a couple of years and slowed it down and got on ABC. And then I re-recorded it and put the talking in it. And, it's just been a blessing. Yeah.
Man, can you tell me the inspiration behind it, man? I mean, the situation that was going on in your life at that time that made you express yourself the way you express yourself in that song.
Well, there was this young kid. His dad used to work on my house. He was a carpenter. He always told me about his son could write songs and stuff like that. And so I resisted for a long time. And finally, you know, he came over and we started writing songs. And he would always tell me he had to be inspired to write songs. And I was like, no. I said, at Motown, they go to work every day and they write songs, you know. Uh-huh. And so he came over to the house, you know, so I instilled that in him. So he came over to the house one day and he was like, I'm ready to write. And I was like, oh, I don't really feel like it. Me and my girl got into it last night. And he was like, well, what if you worked at Motown? And you'd have to write. And I said, yeah. And so then we went and sat down at the piano and started working on it. And boom, there it was, right? Because I love it. Yeah.
Listen, I found a live version of the song, man. It's about, it's like 11 minutes long, right?
Oh, man.
It's 11 minutes long because I guess people were asking you to come back on stage, man, to keep going. They couldn't get enough of it. But before we head into it, man, and I heard you put that trademark in the last song, the brand new song, just a little bit. It was in the background, just a little bit. So, I mean, man, can you give us just a little taste of that a cappella, man, before I play it?
Girl, you know I love you, no matter what you do. And I hope you understand me, every word I say is true. Cause I love you,
Man, listen, let me go
ahead. Right, coming out the kitchen, y'all.
I'm gonna play this live version right quick. We'll come back. We're gonna go past 10 o'clock, if y'all don't mind. At least 10, 15 minutes past 10 o'clock. But y'all check out my brother Lenny Williams do his thing on Radio Free 102.3 KJLH. They don't know if to make love or to fight. What did he say?
No, uh-uh.
It's a fight song, right? Here we go.
Girl, you know you understand me, every word I say is true, cause I love you, baby, I'm thinking of you, trying to be more of a man for you. We'll be right back.
Down the wrong road. I was down and out. I didn't have nobody. And my mother and father, they went on in a long time ago. Yes, they did. And they left me here. They turned their back on me when all my money ran low. You see, baby, I used to cry myself to sleep all night long. And you know, one time things got so bad until I had to go to one of my friends and talk to him. And I told him, I said, you know, I'm having problems with the woman that I love. It seems that I've been calling her on the phone and I just can't get her to answer. And then I went to her house and I saw her car parked in the driveway. I knocked on the door, but still my knocks went unanswered. And then I went home and I watched television until television went off. And then I played my records until I just didn't want to hear them anymore. And finally I went to bed, but I found myself waking up a few hours later. And the tears were running down my face. And my friend told me, he said, Lenny, you ought to forget about her. And you ought to find you somebody else. But you know, your friends can give you the wrong advice sometimes. And I told my friend, I said, maybe you've never been in love like I've been in love. And maybe you've never felt the things that I felt. But this is what I told my friend. I said, you know, sometimes you get lonely. You get lonely. You get lonely. You get lonely. And I cried. And then it got so bad. But you know, I find that so many folks are ashamed to say that they cried behind the one they love. But you know, I found out that love is a very strange thing. Sometimes love only comes once in a lifetime. And if you find yourself losing it, if it takes crying to keep it, then go ahead and cry. And if there's anybody here that ever cried behind the one you love and you're not ashamed, I want to hear you say, yeah! 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 Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, oh. Oh, Oh, yeah. And then it got so bad. It got so bad. So one time I thought I'd roll myself up in a big old ball and die. And then I met you, darling, and you smiled at me. Oh, oh, it was such a pretty smile, yes it was. And you reached out your hand. You helped me.
You helped me.
You helped me.
You helped me.
God, my God, my God. Lenny, they still respond that way to this day, huh? Don't they? When you sing that song.
I love that song. Yeah, they get excited. Yeah, I do too. I get excited too.
Yeah. Oh, man, man. That song will never, ever go away, man. That's a classic that will never, ever die. It's a masterpiece, man. And
let's
you did it.
Not. Let's hope it never goes away. Yeah,
and you
right.
did it. Well, man, we're running out of time. Well, we ran out of time, but I wanted to give you your props and to say thank you for joining me tonight, my brother. I've been knowing you for some years, and I'm glad you accepted my invitation to come on tonight to present some of your music and just to kind of reminisce, man. Almost 50 years in the business strong, and you're still doing it, my brother, man. Continue doing what you do, man. We love you that much, too.
I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much, Kevin. Yeah.
No problem, man. So any closing remarks you want to, you know, tell your fans and people who support you and your music?
Yeah, I just want to let them know that I really appreciate, you know, everything that they do, you know, buying the records, buying the CDs, calling the radio station, requesting the music, coming out to the shows, you know, spending the money to come out to the shows. And I want to know that I appreciate it and I definitely don't take it for granted. And I hope they know that that I never ever will take their support for granted.
Keep up the great work, man. I love you, my brother. We'll be in contact. All right.
All right, Jay.
Stay home and stay safe. Jay must have went to bed, man. Jay got to be on the radio, I guess, in the morning with Steve Harvey.
Oh, okay.
Early
cool.
in the morning,
okay.
so he took off, my brother.
All right, you be good now, Kev.
Okay, all brother. All right, man, we're out.
Okay.
All right, everybody, that was Mr. Lenny Williams on Radio Free, 102.3 KJLH. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
102.3 Radio Free, KJLH, Compton, Los Angeles, Long Beach, and Inglewood. Broadcasting live from the 1-800 The Law.